Hello viewers, welcome to educators.com. This is Venkat Ramna Ganji. In the previous session, we have discussed what is an action bar and what are the prerequisites to start with action bar design and development. Now let us see how to create an action bar in our application. So open your Android Studio, create a new project and name it as action bar. As we discussed in the previous session, so action bar concept has been introduced in 3.0 and the greater versions have action bar, and of course with the support libraries even we can work on lower versions as well. So just take Honeycomb or API 11 as your minimum SDK, click on next and choose your empty activity or blank activity. So if you want to design your own menu XML, so then go with empty activity, or else defaultly. So if you take basic activity, it defaultly available with one of the menu settings item. So that is up to you what you choose. So project has built successfully. So let's start with activity main.xml. If you observe here, defaultly the action bar is available for us Android as we choose the level number 11, okay, or else even the compatible activities it will be. If you are taking the support libraries in your Java, it automatically comes like this. And if you really want to see whether if your application is set with your action bar or not, open your manifest.xml file and find the theme, Android theme, it is style/app theme, so which has been created in your styles.xml file. So open your resource directory, go to values, so check styles.xml, what exactly the style it has been came up. See, app theme parent is theme.appcompat light.dark action bar. If you don't want to use the existing action bar, just simply change this to no action bar, light no action bar. So automatically, so the action bar will not be visible to the user. Let me try with that. So no action bar, save it, come back to your, so see the action bar has been removed, okay. So defaultly when you create, it will be there. So let us say dark action bar, save this. As we have discussed in the previous sessions, now create your menu resource by right click on the create a directory, right click on your resource folder and name it as menu, and inside menu create your menu resource file. So we already know how to create all these things. So create your menu resource and add items whatever you are expecting. As we discussed in the previous session, download the icon set. So from your developer site, extract and whatever you require. So open those files, you'll find three folders, Android, iOS, web, go for Android and choose all the directories, copy them and paste it in your project. So instead of pasting it in the drawable folder, directly right click on your resource directory, paste it. So automatically the corresponding five items or how many items it will be in a single pack, copied over here. Do all the things for whatever you required. So I have copied all the images what I required, all the icons, material icons like a call icon, forward, home button icon, search and settings icons. Okay, let's open your menu.xml file. So defaultly, so we already discussed how to create a menu resource. Now apart from that, in our previous session we did not discuss about how to add an icon. If you want to add an icon for menu item, just simply use the attribute of Android:icon. So this must be a drawable resource. So here I'm going to use this for a new where I'm going to start my new activity when I click on this. So for that I'm going to use IC forward white icon. So it is going to display a forward icon for me. And do the same for remaining. So one is for call, another one is for search and all. Set the icons for each and every menu item. So I have set the icons for everything, call, search and settings. So we already know how to add this to your main activity. You simply call your on create options menu. So add your menu resource. That's it. How do we add? Using menu inflator. So we already discussed this. So I have created options menu. Now, so handle the click events for your menu items by implementing on options item selected. Okay. So I have set the click event also for each and every menu item. So let's run this application and see how it is going to look like on your emulator. So it will take some time to load on the emulator. Please wait. So it has successfully loaded on your emulator. So it is showing the menu items for me, new call and all. I did not set anything so far, but it is visible. Now for this, I would like to set it on an action bar. So I want to read this action bar or get action bar, and I want to show this as in a home. So I want to set an icon for this action home icon, home icon to this action bar as well. So open your activity.java and load your action bar here. Simply call action bar. Is equals to, we use get action bar. So if you are working on later versions or greater versions than 3.0, you can use get action bar directly. Or if you want that to have a support for lower versions as well, use get. Okay. So you go with get support action bar. You'll find get support action bar. So now there won't be any error for this. So you can set a home icon for this. Simply action bar dot. You can use set background drawable or set content view like this. Set display home as enabled. So you can see all of them. We'll have set logo. Yeah, set icon or set logo. So we have to set logo. So this is a drawable resource. R dot drawable dot. So it's in home icon actually. Yeah, home icon. Save this. Usually it will take the version of home 14 version and all. It's not an issue. Just run this application now. And even I want to set some of the icons here in your action bar. So for that, go to your menu.xml file. Open your menu.xml file. So here, show this. We have an attribute called show as action. If you say as always, it will be show always. See, when I said always, the icon has been set to always here, and it is showing the remaining call, search and settings only. So if you set it as if room, it will show when the room is available for that. So, and next for the call also, I'm setting it as save this. So it is asking us to add an XMLS resource auto. Okay, come here, open this, add it. So instead of Android colon, use app colon. So show as action. Immediately it will throw you an error. So Alt Enter, add this. It is going to add an XML namespace with this RES auto, resource auto, and change it here same with app namespace. Save it. For this, I'm not going to show this as action, never. that it is never going to be visible to the user. It is always in overflow menu only. Even for settings also, I am doing the same thing. And prefix must be app. Change it to app. Save this. Now run your application. Have set call and what you can say. Yeah, so for new, I set it as if room is available, it will show. See, default it is showing both, because the room is available for this, it is showing. If you set if there is no room, it won't be visible actually. As I said, never, it is not showing. Even if you try to change with if room, and even for the settings also, set it as if room is available, show that, and run your application. Just have a look. So, though it is showing only the first two, so because for the remaining two will be available here as this, and because the room is not available for them. So it will take the higher priority from the one, whatever you decide, the order you specified in your menu resource directory. So I'm going to set call is always, and for this is also always. Save this, and now set the listener for this. When I click on this, something should be happen, and at the same time, I'm expecting the home enabled here. So for this, action bar dot set display home as enabled, so this must be true. So to set it as enabled true. So this is how it displays the action buttons here. So when I now let me create a new activities, when I click on this next button, it is going to start a new activity for me. When I click on a call button, it should trigger call. So now, so just simply when I click on this, it should start a new class. So we already discussed how to create an intent. Okay, so explicit intent, just give the person a context. So get application context and your target. So give your target class name. I'm going to say new activity dot class, end with semicolon, start activity, pass your intent object, and create new activity. We already discussed how to create a new activity. So I have created a new activity. Just click on run. So have a look at this. It has successfully launched. Now click on next button. It is starting a new activity. So, but I want this, whatever the action buttons I have created must be come to this next activity, and I need a home enabled also. So now come back to your new activity. So new activity.java. So get your action bar here. So directly you can write, or else simply you can look like this. Get action bar dot. Set display home as enabled. Okay, it will, so set it true. Save this. So it is giving some warning for us. It may throw a error for us. So you can add. So run this. Unfortunately, it has been stopped. So come back here, check the reason. Okay. Unable to start an activity component information. So null point exception. So set enabled as. So for this, because we did not set anything. So come back here. Simple, call your action bar. get support action bar and use action bar object. Save this. Run now. So it has successfully launched on the screen. AVD, click on next. So now this back button is enabled, but when I click on this, nothing is happening. So how to set the parent now? So go to your manifest.xml file. So choose your activity. Here inside this, you should set your parent. Okay. So for the second activity, I would like to set the parent. Okay. So parent activity name. So this is going to where when I click on a back button, it should go to main activity. And even I can change the icon as well. So I mean, sorry, title. So default it is showing action bar, but user should know where is his location. Now, where he is in your new activity. So for that, use your title. I think it's a title. Sorry, it's a label, not title. It's a label, Android label. This must be a string resource. So create a string resource, okay, and give that name as new activity. Save this and come back to your string.xml, create that. So even we can change the icon also for this. So change the Android icon. It is going to come from the drawable. Choose your icon, whatever you would like to go with. Just simply, I'm just taking some normal dummy one. So run it now. So click on next. See, the name has been changed. When I click on back, it will come to your action bar activity. Now let me create an action for your call button. When I click on this, it should call, start a call. So we have discussed this, how to trigger call in your implicit intents. Just do the same thing for it. So I'm done with creating action call intent. And for this, as we discussed, you must have a call phone permission in your manifest.xml file. And I set a toast for the remaining two menu items, search and settings. Let's run this application and have a look. It has been launched. So click on next. It is showing a new activity. Again, it is as set home display as enabled. Just click on back. It will go to your main activity. Click on call button. It is taking a new call. So this is how we work with action buttons. To support lower versions, we should add metadata. So add metadata. And dot support dot. So you'll have parent. So give your parent activity. It is not showing annotations because we are working with the latest things. So just sorry. Another one as values. So give it as main activity. Save it. So okay, parent activity name is only used higher versions, of course. It's not an issue. So save this. So the remaining will be in overflow menu. So click on search. I have just clicked a, I set a small toast for these two menu items. You can implement your own in the real world. So thanks for watching educators.com. Let's catch up in the next session.